In this example, we are given that an AC voltage is given as E is equals to E1 sin omega t plus E2 cos omega t, and we are required to find the RMS value of this voltage. Now, in this problem, we are given that this AC EMF is E1 sin of omega t plus E2 cos of omega t. Here we can reduce this function in a single trigonometric form by substituting. Here we can write E1 as E0 cos theta, and we can substitute E2 as E0 sin theta. See what we'll be getting here. This EMF will become E0 sin omega t cos theta plus E0 cos omega t sin theta, which will reduce in the form E0 sin of omega t plus theta. Here the value of the EMF E0 we can calculate by squaring and adding these functions. You can see we'll get E1 square plus E2 square is equals to, on the right hand side, it will be E0 square, or E0 we can write as root of E1 square plus E2 square. So in this situation, if this function is reduced in this form, we can write that E0 is the peak value of this alternating EMF. So here the RMS value, we know it can be given as E0 by root 2 for any sinusoidal EMF. So this will be given as root of E1 square plus E2 square by 2. That will be the answer to this problem. And you can also solve this alternatively. We talk about alternative method to solve this problem. This can be directly calculated by the function we use for calculation of ERMS, which is root of 1 by time period, which is 2 pi by omega, integration from 0 to 2 pi by omega EMF as a function of time square into dt, because this function is giving us mean square value of the alternating EMF, and this overall value will be giving us the root mean square value. This is the mean square value. Here we are calculating the average of squares, and then we are taking the root. So, either ways you can directly calculate. So, be careful about the analysis.